YouTube. Please check to make sure you're still subscribed to this channel, as people get unsubscribed from my channel without their knowledge every day. And if you have not subscribed, please do so. You don't want to miss any Rise of Skywalker breaking news this December. To quote Han Solo, here's where the fun begins. Thank you, and enjoy the video. I have received a new batch of leaks from my source, and if they are accurate, one horrific leak in particular will absolutely demonstrate not only what a degraded abomination Rise of Skywalker truly is, but also just how shameless Jar Jar Abrams is in desperately trying to pander to the very fans Lucasfilm has insulted and ignored for years. Treat this information as rumor and take it with a grain of salt, but what I'm about to tell you fits in very neatly with Abrams' established modus operandi, and so I've decided to report this as rumor. Warning, major spoilers may lie ahead. With The Force Awakens, Abrams promised a rich and lavish meal to starving Star Wars fans after a 10-year famine in theaters. And yet, when dinner time came, fans found themselves served lukewarm leftovers from the original Star Wars, a mashed-up potato of a film consisting of original Star Wars elements pureed into a tepid gruel that fans choked down with a grateful cheer, because no one is more enthusiastic for a lousy meal than those who are starving. But once they returned home with full bellies, fans had time to reflect. And what did that reflection yield? Abrams had conned them. They were promised a new Star Wars movie, but what they got was an old Star Wars movie that had been ripped apart and put back together again with one piece forgotten. The heart. That's what Abrams does. He takes works created by better people, takes those works apart, then puts them back together absent a few parts that Jar Jar Abrams didn't consider all that important. The heart, the soul, the guts, the canon. Jar Jar works his magic on a film like Star Trek or Star Wars, something very anticipated, something for which the audience is starving. Then once the fans devour it and realize they've been had, Abrams has fled like a swarm of locusts to another franchise to strip it bare. Star Trek died in his wake. Now Star Wars is likewise dead. But there's one problem for Abrams here. He made one mistake. He returned to the scene of the crime. Abrams plunged the dagger into Star Wars with The Force Awakens, laid the seeds of ruin that would eventually kill it, then moved on. But greed lured him back to the scene of the crime, and too late he realized, as he tried to mount this sequel, that Star Wars was a corpse that had his fingerprints all over it. He had to do something to save himself. But what? The answer was clear. He's going to rip off yet another film to try to save himself? Weekend at Bernie's. Yes, friends, Star Wars Episode 9 should be titled Weekend at Palpatine's, because Abrams is shamelessly grave-robbing every corpse he can find to parade it around for one last necromantic show. Consider, Palpatine is clearly dead. Go back and watch the second Death Star get violently blown to smithereens and tell me Palpatine is not dead. It's a vicious explosion. It's like every atom had a stick of dynamite it used as a strap-on to sodomize other atoms similarly inclined, all singing Ride of the Valkyries together in German. An atomic dynamite gangbang with chest plates and lederhosen, you can't get a bigger bang than that, folks. And yet, Palpatine is alive because Jar Jar Abrams needed a bad guy to make up for Rian Johnson idiotically killing Snoke. So here we go. Weekend at Palpatine's. Abrams ties the wires to Sheev's dead body, jerks him around on the wires, rewrites all of his old dialogue from Return of the Jedi, and voila! Abrams rides again, driving another franchise right over the cliff. Never mind that Palpatine surviving Return of the Jedi completely invalidates the triumph of the original trilogy, completely ruins Vader's redemption, completely hollows out the victory of the rebellion. Jar Jar just needs the corpse to twitch a little while longer. Same thing with Princess Leia. Carrie Fisher has sadly passed, but that's not going to stop Jar Jar. No. In Weekend at Palpatine's, all the bodies get wired to jerk around one last time. They digitally resurrect Carrie Fisher with old footage, as well as CGI that I'm informed by my sources at times cringeworthy, though they may polish that at the last minute, who knows. But even worse than that, they desecrate Leia's character as well by turning her into a Jedi she never was for no other reason than to have Kylo use her non-existent lightsaber she never built later on in the film, fighting alongside Rey to kill the deceased Palpatine who isn't there. Well, I guess it makes a certain amount of sense to use a weapon that doesn't exist from a character that never built it to kill a guy who isn't there because he's already dead. That's consistency, right? But now we come to the coup de grace, the crap de la crap, one of the stupidest things I've ever heard about Rise of Skywalker. Han is coming back as a Force ghost. That's right, gang. According to my source, and I must report this as rumor pending further verification, in Weekend at Palpatine's, they dig up Han, tie wires to him, and jerk him and the audience around as Abrams forces Han Solo into the story. Pun intended. See, Abrams is trying to atone for his cinematic sins here. In The Force Awakens, Abrams banished Luke to an island and refused to show him until the final shot of the film, depriving fans of the chance to see Jedi Master Luke Skywalker in action. He killed Han Solo, ensuring there would never be a Luke-Han-Leia reunion, and depriving fans of what they most wanted to see, and so now he's going to give us a craven, disingenuous, idiotic square-up at any cost. He's bringing Han back as a Force ghost. Bringing Han back in the most insulting way possible. Why is this insulting to fans? Because we're not idiots! Han Solo was many things, but he was not a Jedi. He was not a Force user. And so the idea that he could use the Force to come back to speak to Kylo and try to talk him out of the whole pouty evil thing is abhorrent. If Han Solo can come back as a Force ghost, then that makes Yoda, Obi-Wan, and Anakin's appearances virtually meaningless. Trampling all over canon again. If Han can come back as a Force ghost, anyone can come back as a Force ghost. In fact, if this rumor is true and Han comes back as a Force ghost, we need to drop the whole Force part of that phrase and just call it like we see it. Han, Yoda, Obi-Wan, and Anakin are just plain ghosts. The Force has nothing to do with it anymore. Yep. Forget the larger Star Wars series, forget the idea of canon mattering in the Star Wars universe. Abrams and Kennedy will do whatever they want, whenever they want, regardless of whether or not it makes sense, because at this point, I suspect, they're scared. I suspect they realize, at last, only too late, just how badly they screwed up. And I don't think Star Wars Episode 9, Weekend at Palpatine's, is going to fix things. Some things you can't fix with wires and puppets. Apparently, according to my source, we're going to get even more Force ghosts along the way. Again, I am presenting this as rumor only, but according to my source, it's confirmed Jedi ghost voices are heard during the final battle. Luke, Leia, Yoda, Obi-Wan, voiced by both Guinness and McGregor, and interestingly enough, a voice believed to be Ahsoka, and another female voice my source could not identify. The voices apparently all blend together and you hear lines overlapping. Luke or Leia will then have the final line that gives Rey the resolve to strike down the toxic white male corpse with wires once called Palpatine. So this raises a couple of questions, one somewhat minor and one unbelievably massively major. If Ahsoka is indeed presented as a Force voice, does that mean that Disney has killed her to make Rey shine ever more as the bestest ever? Or did Lucasfilm forget that Ahsoka is still alive? But even worse than this, it is now canon that Force ghosts can strike out with Force lightning like Yoda did in The Last Jedi. And if that's the case, then what the actual hell are these ghosts doing here? They're talking? They're rooting Rey on? Cheerleading her to beat Palpatine? They're not joining in, not zapping Palpatine with Force lightning and disintegrating his wired, dead, toxic ass? In a recent article, it was stated that Disney has officially codified Force ghosts using lightning into canon, which begs the question, why aren't the Force ghosts helping Rey in the final battle with more than jumbled up audio clip advice? In fact, why would the Force ghosts even wait for Rey to get the Sith dagger MacGuffin and find Palpatine? Why didn't all the Force ghosts who actually dealt with Palpatine before get together about 10 years earlier and zap him out of existence? Why weren't Force ghosts going around and destroying First Order ships and walkers with absolute impunity? There would be no way to fight back against Force ghosts. They're ghosts! Shell them, shoot them, throw holy water on them, the power of Christ compels you, curse at them with Ouija boards, they're just gonna fry your ass with lightning. Once again, weekend at Palpatine's, now the Force ghosts have wires tied to them, undermining all logic and common sense and established canon to force these puppets to dance to Abrams' tune, if this rumor is true. Tell me, if Force ghosts can use Force lightning on the living, then why the hell didn't Yoda and Obi-Wan join Luke and take care of Vader and Palpatine in Return of the Jedi? Why didn't Obi-Wan appear with Luke to take on Vader in Empire? They come up with these stupid story ideas because in the moment they feel good, but then they don't consider what these cool new ideas do to the rest of the series. Palpatine's back? The original trilogy is trashed. Han Solo is a Force ghost? There goes the lore that says Force ghosts have to, you know, have the Force. Force ghosts can use lightning from beyond? There goes every major battle in Star Wars history. Also, Abrams can add his little narrative lens flares. This is sad, people. If Han's Force ghost appears to Kylo Ren, this is a stinging indictment of the narrative integrity of Lucasfilm as a whole and Abrams individually, damning proof that Lucasfilm has not only abandoned Star Wars canon, but all pretense of adherence to logic. Get ready, people. Star Wars Episode 9, Weekend at Palpatine's, is coming this Christmas to a theater near you.
Ha ha ha.